Tyler, what is going on with this hockey team that we're seeing all of this offense in these past four games?
Yeah, I think all four lines are just clicking right now. We're getting a lot of shots on net, and you know, our skill takes over from there. So guys are playing well, and hopefully we can just continue and keep on growing.
He's two shutouts of Dallas. It's his career number 17, and that ties Ben Bishop, most in franchise history. From your perspective, how he's played, what he means, and the confidence he's instilling.
Yeah, I mean, I think you're only really as good as your goaltender, and luckily for us, we have Azzy back there. He's been tremendous for us. He's a backbone. You know, our team sometimes gives up a little bit too many high-scoring danger area shots, but, you know, we can always rely on Azzy. So when he gets games like this and gets the shutouts, you know, we try to do everything we can for him. You know, he definitely deserves it.
Tyler, thank you so much. Congratulations on the win. We'll see you Saturday for Montreal.
Hey, thank you.
Steven, another six-goal night for you guys. What a difference a week can make for you guys. Just kind of what's feeling good about your game right now?
Well, like I said after last game, I mean, we weren't too worried. We got way too much talent on this team to not score goals. So you play the right way. You know, you get some chances early and some looks on the power play, which is going well lately, and we capitalized on a team that maybe just came out a little flat. So another big win for us, and all over the sheet, you got the power play, the penalty kill, the goaltending, and it was a good solid win.
You get four goals in basically the first 12 minutes of the game, and then you have to manage the game for the rest of the game. I mean, how hard is that to do sometimes when you're out to a big lead like that?
Yeah, it's something that it's kind of tough. I mean, you think you're up 4-0, but you just got to continue to play solid, and I thought we did that. We stayed disciplined. We knew, you know, they might get a couple calls their way. You know, we had the good kill there, and we just did the right things. Sometimes it's kind of boring after you know, when you get out to a lead, you just want to play that boring game and just get pucks in deep and you know, kind of preserve the lead. And I thought we did that. We were able to add a few because we played the right way, and it was a good win.
When you guys are playing the way that you have been for the last couple of games, how much fun is it out there for you guys?
Yeah, it's a ton of fun to come to the rink every day when things are going as well as they have this year. You know, we're a group that you know, our tendency is to have some fun and relax and enjoy yourself. And when you're doing that, you're usually playing some good hockey and you're playing with confidence. So there's a fine line there. You still got to go out and get better and want more, which this group has a good combination of so far this year.
That's a good defensive team over there. They came in second in the league in fewest goals allowed. Is there something that you were able to do in the first period to kind of exploit?
Like I said, we started the game and scored our chances. Obviously, you know, you get a power play goal early. But I thought for us, when we're on our game, we're creating some offensive zone time and we're getting calls. You know, when things weren't going as well, it was one lucky to get two power plays a game. It's an addictive thing for us that we don't have the puck as much and we're not creating as much. So today we got those two early looks. We get some good chances, we score and kind of settle down and then obviously pounce on them.
You said you weren't worried
by Nikita Kucherov. He's got 11 points in his past three games.
Yeah, I mean, we sitting here, like we said, I mean, we weren't joking. We said, you know, we're not worried about Cooch when he goes through a little slump, and a slump for him is, you know, a point a game maybe, but... It's amazing when he's feeling it. It's so fun to watch, and he's a huge part of our offensive success.
Kevin, they're the second best defensive team in the league in terms of goals given up. Was there something that you guys were able to kind of take advantage of in that first period?
I don't know. We just came out hard, and we just want to play our way, and you know, stick to our structure, and you know, good things happen when we play the right way, and you know, it paid off.
Speaking of playing the right way, you're up 4-0 after the first period. Is it difficult to keep playing the right way when you have a big lead like that?
I think everybody understands the situation. We put ourselves after the first period, and we just wanted to, you know, stick to the game plan, and you know, keep you know, put puck behind the G's and go on the forecheck. And you know, sometimes it's hard, but you just have to, you know, be smart, I guess.
You did tell us after the game the other night that wins are what are the most important to you, but you do have 11 points in your last three games. How conscious are you of that?
Not thinking about it. You know, we won today. It's good.
How important was it for you guys to finish out the game and get the shutout for Vazzy?
It's huge. He's been unbelievable for us throughout the whole season, and, you know, he's... he's top goalie in the league, and you know, especially for him, as you said, after the first period we were up for nothing, and we just want to make sure we play smart and don't give up chances, and you know, it's good for him that he keep the net.
I know goals have been tough to come by for Sergachev this year, but what do you think about his shot tonight and the way he's been playing overall second year?
He's got a good shot, and you know, he finally changed his stick, and it's paid off, I guess.
What's different about your team confidence?
I mean, we know we're a good team, and we know we have great players, skilled, fast, and we play hard. So that's just what we had to do, and we did it, and we did it for 60, so yeah.
A week ago, we were wondering if this team forgot how to score goals. You've been shut out for the second time in a week. Since then, it's been five or more in four straight games. Something that just kind of re-clicked, or just you guys getting back to who you are?
Yeah, I mean, we're just getting back to who we are, and we're just shooting pucks, and, you know, obviously our big guys making great plays and power plays clicking, so, I mean, it's been great.
Second now, year now, you get to play with Nikita Kucherov. Just what kind of a talent is he to kind of have on the ice?
I mean, he's probably like top five player in the league, and if not the best now, he's has about 100 points already. So, I mean, it's great. He'll always find you, and he'll always shoot the puck, and he sees openings that not a lot of guys in this league see. So, I mean, it's just, it's like playing with Vasi too. Like, it's a confidence boost, you know, like when you know when you're playing and Vasi's behind you. He makes some crazy stuff on the blue line, and, you know, you can play with confidence. So same thing with Cooch. When you know when you're on the ice with him, you can make plays.
Golden, how do you feel about your game individually?
I mean, I still have turnovers and not great defensive plays, but I feel like I'm getting there. And, I mean, watching videos with the coaches and working practices. So, I mean, I feel like I'm getting there, yeah.
Let's get the scoop from Coop and hear John Cooper's post-game press conference as tonight presented by Carrabba's Italian Grill.
I know you won a lot of games, but is it rare that you have a game to get out on a fast start, manage a third period, kind of a stress-free night, relatively speaking?
They're never stress-free. the one thing is, it's tough. You jump out to a 4-0 lead in the first period. You know, we were in the locker room. We didn't think it was a 4-0 game. You know, but pucks were going in the net for us, and we capitalized on our opportunities. When that happens, you're really putting a team on its heels. It was, how are we gonna handle this? And, you know, we got a couple more in the second. The power play did what it had to do, and then you get to the third, and you're playing for your goalie. And, you know, we gave up 7 shots. I'm sure they were, you know, probably didn't have the zip in their step they had in the first period, but still, you got to handle that. And you're playing for your goalie in the third, and that's what they did.
Goals have been harder to come by for Sergachev this year, but you mentioned before how his game's taken a step from last year. How would you describe the difference in terms of
games? Well, I think a lot of times players will base their game on points. Coaches don't. Are they nice to have? There's no question. Do you need goals to win games? Of course you do. But when you're up a goal late, you don't really need the other goal. You need to be able to defend. And those are parts of the game that he has just gotten better at and better at. And you just watch him, his poise going back for pucks, where he might have been maybe unsure a little bit last year. So much more confidence going back. He's using his big frame he has now, and that's all just part of growth, and that's what's happening.
You're running out of ways to describe Nikita Kucherov's game.
Now I'm so much more comfortable now.
Do you find ways that you can keep describing the way Nikita Kucherov can play? 11 points in 3 games.
Yeah, that you know, as the game's going on, I don't know who's really getting the assists and stuff like that. Like, you're watching the plays be made, and then you're jumping ahead to who are they putting out the next and on all these other things. And, you know, I went in after the first period and saw you had 3 points. And geez, the kid's hot. But this is how it goes for scorers. And you want consistency in your game, and he's been pretty darn consistent all year. you know, this little stretch when we weren't scoring, and but nobody was scoring. It wasn't just him. But he's a dynamic player. And when he's shooting the puck like he was tonight, and you know, that goal he scored was effortless, you know, just on and off his stick. You just got to keep throwing him out there because you take advantage of when he's rolling like that. But, you know, are you going to get 3 and 4 points a night? Probably not, but he's on the finds himself on the score sheet more often than not, and big part of our team. Let's not being captain obvious there. But it's, you know, his entire game is, it just, he just keeps improving, and, you know, can't be anything but happy for him.
I was sitting right here Saturday, and I asked you after he had a minus four night against Pittsburgh, victory. You weren't worried about him. Why weren't you worried about him?
Well, part of it is because I know him. I've been around him quite a bit. I've watched him grow as a player, as a human. I've watched him, you know, become a dad. And if you're naive to sit here and think in 82 games you're not going to have one where the stats aren't on your side. And you just go back and you talk about it. And the one thing is that's where he's, I think he's said it. You know, he's grown where the frustration, everybody gets frustrated, but you learn to brush it off a little bit more as you, I guess, age and get experience, and that's what he does. And you just turn the page. As we tell our guys, you got to turn the page in this league because the games come at you, you know, fast. And can't hang on to things, and he didn't, and look where he's at.
Nobody is on the score sheet very much, Adam Arney. But what kind of game did he have tonight in terms of his impact on?
Well, it's hard to really criticize anybody's game tonight. But you look at chances we gave up, we weren't. But everybody was skating, including Adam. He had a big hit first period, I think. And you know, he's obviously getting under guys' skin because Ben took a penalty on him there in the third period. And he just went about his business, but he was using his legs, using his body. When he's doing that, it's a good sign.